Hi, everyone. On October 8th, the church celebrates the former courtesan and actress of Antioch named Pelagia, often surnamed Pelagia the Penitent. Now, St. Pelagia was a woman who was extremely beautiful, extremely intelligent, very rich, and had spent much of her young life on the stage entertaining people. However, this wasn't to be enough for her, and eventually her soul became blackened enough through the other activities that she was engaged in that she began to become a courtesan. Now, a courtesan in those days was someone who was essentially a prostitute, and the activities that she engaged in had increased her riches by just an exponential amount. She was very famous and was known all around Antioch and the surrounding provinces. However, the Lord had something different for her in mind. There was a very pious bishop named Nonnos, and he is actually a saint of the church, also commemorated on November 10th. Now, Nonnos was together with a number of other bishops who were meeting outside to discuss a particular church problem in Antioch at that time. And as it happened, Pelagia and her entourage, including a number of slaves, were coming up to where the bishop was. And it was said that the air was completely inundated with the richness of her perfume. And all of the other bishops looked up and saw that she was coming, and they turned their heads away because they did not want to be tempted by her or to be shamed by her. But Nonnos was fascinated. He looked at her and he examined her very, very closely. And then he turned and he wept. And when asked why he was weeping, he said, "Because, brethren, look at this. She, in her desire to please men, is so completely adorned with beauteous things all over her, her clothes, her jewels, everything. And yet we, who have the Christian faith, refuse to be equally adorned by the virtues in order to cover up our own sins." No doubt, these other bishops were somewhat scandalized by the fact that Nonnos was paying so much attention to this woman. But in the end, they understood what he was saying. And in fact, what he was preaching, not long afterward, Pelagia again came upon him and was listening to him. And she was so quickened in her heart, she was so stricken in her soul by the words that he was saying, that she also came to an understanding of the misery and degradation of the life that she had been leading and of the sins that she had been engaged in. So she sent a note to Bishop Nonnos and said that she wished to meet with him and discuss these things with him. Now, he was very afraid at the time of meeting with her alone. So he said, "Well, come to the church, and there in front of myself and all the other bishops, you can tell your story and ask what it is that you want." And so Pelagia did this, and she was essentially begging that she be allowed to be baptized and that she allowed to be entered the Christian faith, because she was so ashamed of the things that she had been doing, and God had spoken to her and it so convicted her heart. However, the other bishop said that, "No, we just can't baptize one in that position, a courtesan, unless we know assuredly that she's not going to return to her former life." And Pelagia fell on her knees and begged them and said, "Look, it is certainly possible that I will return to my former life if I'm not baptized. And so you must do this. You please must do this." And so Bishop Nonnos gave in to her demands and indeed did baptize Pelagia, who at that time was known as Margaro or Margaret, and he gave her this new name. Now, there was a deaconess there, Romana, who served as her sponsor. And she was instructing Pelagia and talking with Pelagia. And under the next few days, Pelagia underwent terrible torments about returning to her former life, not unlike what Mary of Egypt, another great a saint of the desert who had a similar background, said that for 17 years she was tempted by the things that she had done. But Pelagia finally decided to leave the area and to go to Jerusalem. And so one night, by stealth, she did such. And she went to the Mount of Olives and lived there, disguising herself as a man and living in a cell alone. Romana, her sponsor, was terribly upset by this. But after a while, Iacobus, the deacon to Bishop Nonnos, was instructed to go to Jerusalem for various reasons. And Bishop Nonnos said, while you're there, please seek out a monk named Pelagius, because he is very holy and he will give you good instruction. And so Iacobus did this when he got to Jerusalem and went to the Mount of Olives and sought out this Pelagius. And opening the door, our divine Pelagia recognized Iacobus, but he did not recognize her, because for the past 3 years she had been undergoing such tremendous ascetical labors that her eyes were sunken, she was shrunken in face, darker in countenance, and completely divested of the former beauty that she had. But Iacobus spent some time with her and was greatly profited by this, and went back and told Nonnos of his story. Now, not long after this, Pelagia, of course, reposed in the Lord at the Mount of Olives, and people from all over Jerusalem and the surrounding countrysides came because they knew of this monk's reputation, and they're going to prepare him for burial. And when doing so, when about to anoint the body, well, lo and behold, it was discovered that Pelagius was indeed a woman. And then all was revealed about the great Pelagia. Pelagia, of course, even to this day, her relics are at the Mount of Olives and a site of sacred pilgrimage for everyone. Her life offers us many, many things in terms of instruction. But perhaps the one that we should most take to heart is the fact that even the most degrading and terribly traumatic experiences that we inflict on ourselves in terms of our own sins are not beyond the Lord's power, who can work miracles in creating a wonderful saint of God through a terrible sinner, though who was once a terrible sinner, and that he can use other people who sometimes might cause scandal by reaching out to those whom others are afraid of. We know that the Lord himself was criticized for going into sinners and eating and conversing with sinners and Samaritans, even by his own disciples. But in this instance, because of the devotion of Bishop Nonnos, his brilliant sermon, and the fact that he found through the Spirit that Pelagia had a willing heart, he was able to create a wondrous and great saint. So by the prayers of both these saints, the sainted Bishop Nonnos and our mother among the saints, Pelagia the penitent, may all of us return to the Lord in penitence as well in order to receive his grace. God bless you all.